Thanks for joining us for another JPRO training video. Today we'll introduce you to how JPRO displays, filters, and monitors data and information. Using the steps we taught you in an earlier video, connect the vehicle to JPRO. Once the connection is complete, let's examine some features on JPRO's home screen. When you first connect, JPRO will display faults and key data points, or KDPs, from the entire vehicle. On the left, you can view the roll call, which lists all components on the vehicle. Selecting a component or system filters the faults and KDPs on the screen to only show data specific to that component. For example, when we select the engine component from roll call, JPRO populates with faults and KDPs for that component, plus pertinent details like make and model information. To go back to viewing the entire vehicle, simply select it from the roll call section. Now that we understand what data is displayed on the home screen, let's introduce a feature called Data Monitor that lets you further explore the data. This feature allows technicians to select and monitor data items from thousands of potential sources. This allows users to track statuses and switches across multiple ECUs to discover irregularities or data points that are out of range. There are multiple tabs that outline vehicle subsystems and data groupings. You can visualize various sets of data, such as power diagrams, switches and status indicators, pressure readings, and more. The All tab lists all components and can be sorted by clicking the column headers. The component dropdown allows you to sort by specific ECU or component. The search function allows you to type in a keyword and view the related data points. For example, if we type in parking, we see results related to the parking brake switch or actuator. Now let's discuss the graphing function. Select the data points using the checkbox on the left side and press the graph button on the bottom of the screen. From here, you can monitor the data points and see how they change as you tug on a wire, engage the parking brake, or perform other activities related to the systems you are monitoring. Back at the main data monitor screen, you can also select and create your own customized data groups. Also, be sure to take notice of the bus statistics button. This feature allows you to monitor traffic and communications on the vehicle data bus. Now we'll go back to the JPRO home screen and examine some features that take much of the same data and present it in a visual format for various systems on the vehicle. Navigate over to the Subsystem Diagnostics button, and you'll find a few options such as fuel, coolant, and aftertreatment. For this example, let's select the aftertreatment diagnostics option. First, you'll notice a checklist of important steps to take when diagnosing aftertreatment issues. Always follow this list carefully because a large portion of aftertreatment issues can be resolved by first verifying items on this list. Now you are presented with a visualization of the aftertreatment system labeled with the same data values you can find in Data Monitor. Notice that you can click on individual components that make up the subsystem and view KDPs related to that component. You're now ready to use heavy-duty data to monitor vehicle issues.